So we are going to the last presenters. That is a well-known person that is coming from Hispania in Rome, Michele Munafò, that is talking about new perspective for remote sensing in the domain of soil sealing.
Morning. Good morning, everybody. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I will talk about soil sealing, new perspective for remote sensing. Talking about another perspective, so the one of ISPRA. ISPRA is the Italian Institute for Environmental Protection Research. It's a public body. It's under the vigilance of the Italian Ministry for the Environment. And has several institutional duties, and some of them are related to land monitoring and environmental reporting. And I will speak about some of these, especially concerning land take, land consumption, that is related to soil sealing and artificial land cover growth in Italy. And we work at a national level, but we are part of a national system. And we are every year producing a national report about this topic, and related to land take, land consumption, soil sealing, and also urban sprawl, urban growth analysis and mapping and assessment. Also because in Italy this is a big problem. We have a lot of artificial land cover areas and a big increasing speed of this artificial land cover and the soil sealing, especially in unplanned low density expansion, urban expansion. So this is a big problem that is also recognized at a global and European level. European Union has set a target to achieve zero net land take below the population growth rate by 2030. So this is a big question, and we are trying to answer to some of these questions, at least by the knowledge system. And this is also made by the national system since 2016, a national legislation set up a national environmental protection system that is composed by ISPRA and the regional and the provincial and the local environmental protection agencies in Italy. We are over 10,000 people working in the system, and we have the duty to provide coordinated nationwide environmental monitoring protection. And we have also the power to enforce the adoption of specific technical regulation. This is the these are the all the agencies that are part of the system. This system is responsible for land monitoring activities in Italy and publish, among others, this report every year, land consumption, land processes, and ecosystem services. What is land consumption or land take? There are several terms often used as synonyms, but not often. And of course, we refer to these terms regarding the biophysical point of view for the environment monitoring. So we look at the soil as an environmental resource that is degraded by artificial land cover and soil sealing. And to do this land monitoring activities, of course, we produce maps, and also because our stakeholders are often local authorities, urban planners that need an accurate mapping on urban and land cover
to help decision makers to better understand urban area ecosystems and then take decisions. Of course, Sentinel data can help a lot for these duties, and of course I will go quickly on Copernicus. You heard a lot about it, but I would like to remark that Copernicus activated the generation of open and freely data sets, as already said. In particular, I will talk about a little about the land monitoring service in Copernicus that provides geographical information on land cover and on variables related, for instance, to the vegetation state or the water cycle. And at the European level, the main responsibility is of the European Environment Agency, and Copernicus Land Monitoring Service has four components: a global component, pan-European component, local component, and in situ and reference data component. This is the evolution of the Copernicus Land product and services. Now we are in an operational phase of the service, and this leads to a lot of products that are available at the European and local level. This is the well-known Coril Land Cover, a product that is now part of the Copernicus Land Monitoring Services, but is of course older than Copernicus, since 1990s. It was produced at the European level, and we are working on updating it, referring to 2018 in this month. These are other pan-European products. Here the resolution is higher than Coril Land Cover. Coril Land Cover has a minimum mapping unit of 25 hectares. Here we have a 20 meters resolution and a minimum mapping unit of 400 meters square meter resolution. There are several products, imperviousness degree and built-up areas, tree cover density and forest type, permanent grassland, wetlands and permanent water bodies. Temporal resolution is about 3 years for this data. This is an example of the utility of the high resolution layer. On the left side you can see Coril Land Cover that does not detect any urban areas in this little municipality in Italy. On the right side you can see in red that high resolution layers can detect the urban areas. For urban planning and management is of course very useful the local component of land monitoring service that covers not all the European territory but some specific areas. In this case main urban zones and main cities in Europe, with a special resolution of a quarter of hectare, so very high resolution of this data. What are we done in Italy, we are using, of course, all this data and providing also the national contribution to these products and services, but we are also working on downstream services in the Copernicus land domain, and in particular about soil sealing, land take, land consumption, urban sprawl, and so on. These products are, of course, disseminated by our report, geoportals, websites, and so on, all with an open, free and open policy of the data. And you can see here the main source of information on soil sealing land consumption that we can refer to. You can see the Coril Land Cover with the low resolution, the Urban Atlas on the right, the imperviousness degree, so the high resolution, one of the high resolution layers, and the national map on the right side. The national maps provided by ISPRA and the Italian National System for Environmental Protection. And you can note the difference when classifying also, in particular urban areas and vegetated area inside the urban areas. This is our national report. The integrate Copernicus products and national downstream services for the identification of sustainable land management policies. We have in Italy a triplication of artificial land cover area in the last 60 years. And as I said, open data are available for national local assessment through map services and a database of more than 100 indicators on land consumption, urban sprawl, landscape metrics, and land monitoring for every Italian municipality. This is a quick overview of the results of our monitoring. In Italy, we have more than 23,000 square kilometers sealed. 7.6% of the national land, but you can see, of course, that this, the distribution of this artificial land is not homogeneous on the total land, but it is concentrated in some zones near the metropolitan areas, urban areas, but also in the valley, in the plain, and along the coastline, and so on. And this is the last year monitoring. We have in 2016 had 5,000 hectares sealed in Italy. And you can see in the map where this changes were detected. How we produce this this service, because this is an institutional service for the national community, we have some constraint. First of all, this activity has to be realized all over the Italy at national scale through cooperation of the regional agencies. We have a very short deadline because before summer we have to provide data for the previous year, so we have something like 6 months to produce national data. This is fully realized by internal resources, so ISPRA and the local agencies. We have the activities fully based on processes of satellite data classification, of course, with a big component of photo interpretation and then validation of data with very high resolution images, and then geographic and topographic data integration, GIS modeling for elaboration, environmental indicators computing. This is the typical available data that we use for the process. A different resolution and different sources from satellite images, very high resolution images, commercial data, topographic and local data from regional environmental information system, as well as OpenStreetMap data integrated in the process. The workflow for last year land consumption classification. We have some of the activities that are achieved at a regional scale and some other at national scale. So starting from data collection and image processing, semi-automatic classification and manual classification, data editing, validation, statistic and indicators computation. For the first phase, we are working a lot, of course, on Sentinel-2. We have around every year 3,000 images that we process, 2 terabytes of data every year process. How we, of course, we research and select data, We pre-process data and then derive Bandsat and Mosaic at the regional and interregional level. Then we derive also some classical indexes like NDVI in a multi-temporal way, and also the series of the NDVI for the year, and in order to help the semi-automatic length cover classification. This is an example of multi-temporal NDVI with three different seasons, spring, summer, and autumn. And you can see the difference where clearly we can detect the new infrastructure, new big road realized during the last year. We also use, as I said, the NDVI max to NDVI calculation for every image, and then the calculation of maximum NDVI for every year. The difference on these values can help to detect the changes between one year and the other. Of course, we integrated also semi-automatic classification, mainly in Python and QGIS environment, with identification of samples and then classification system using length cover signature classification technique, and in order to derive other mask of the classification for length consumption. Since last year, we are testing also Sentinel-1 with the selection of intensity and the calculation of the median per pixel to derive difference related to possible changes, mainly on the for the changes, for instance, new built-up areas on already degraded soil. So if the new buildings are located on already non-vegetated area, this could help a lot for our process. This is an example of the change map. You can see in green the area from deriving from the integration of Sentinel-1 and Sentinel-2 masks and verified by photo interpretation. The photo interpretation is very important and very heavy work for us because we have to achieve a very high accuracy. We have a global accuracy of our data more than 98%, and so this is impossible to achieve without manual classification and photo interpretation. Also in these activities, we integrate a lot of data and very high resolution images and orthophotos, other satellite data, but of course other local and in situ data were available, and this is an example of photo interpretation process. This is made on Sentinel-2 data, but of course in some cases we should need a more resolute images. We use also some commercial maps, Google, Bing, and also some Street View for some cases that are difficult to understand by classical photo interpretation. And this is a schema of this work for manual classification that lead to a vector of changes and then through raster process into the new maps for the year we are monitoring. We are also trying to improve the automatic classification in order to reduce the problem of manual classification, and we are working more on Sentinel-1 and Sentinel-2 integration also in some projects and also in collaboration with other institutions like CNR, like University on Rome, Milan, Turin, and so on. The aim is, of course, to improve the automatic classification of built-up. The last phase is, of course, the statistics and indicators producing, and this is done by GIS modeling at national level, and we have a national geodatabase that could be accessed freely on our site website with 1,300 indicators available at national, regional, and local level. Coming soon, this is my last slide, because we are working on the new report. In a few days we are going to present it in Rome in the 17th of July in Palazzo Montecitorio in Rome. Thank you very much for your attention.